Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. And if you're new here, my name is Lauren. Today I'm going to give you my update on Olaplex number 0 and number 3, as well as answering your questions about my hair. So a lot of questions I've already answered in the past few videos, but I do still have a list that I'm just gonna go over. But first, I'm gonna start with the Olaplex update because that was another question that was asked a bunch of times. It wasn't just specifically questions about Olaplex. It was more like I was receiving comments about Olaplex and or suggestions, particularly about putting Olaplex number 0 in a spray bottle and then applying the spray to my hair. And then my first demo and first impressions, I did add water to my hair to fully saturate after applying number 0. I've also had questions about why I don't sleep with number 3 in my hair and all kinds of things. So I'm just going to address the Olaplex questions first. And I did reach out to Olaplex, ask them a lot of questions, and I'm going to go through and read them to you basically, like what I asked and what their response was. So I kind of organized it. So first I'm going to talk about number 0. And if you do not know, number 0 is the primer or the first additional step you could use to amplify the effects of number 3, which is the hair perfector. So number 0 is the intensive bond building hair treatment that primes, repairs, strengthens, and protects all hair types. This is 5.2 ounces, and all of the Olaplex products have their patented and proprietary technology, a proven hair reparative system. This is an intensive bond building treatment, best used as a two-part system with number 3 hair perfector. It strengthens and repairs all types of damaged hair. So that's what you use this for. You are supposed to apply it to dry hair, saturate from root to tip, which that was one of my questions. So apply number 0 to dry hair. You're supposed to fully saturate from root to tip and do not rinse. Leave it on for 10 minutes and then you apply number 3 on top. The effects are supposed to be amplified. So it's supposed to be more repairing on like a deeper level basically. I asked a lot of questions about the comments I was receiving as well as just my own questions that arose like, can I do that? Should I do that? So let's get into it. I'm gonna read it because I don't want to miss something. So for number 0, which is the primer, which I kind of feel like it's more like a serum, but so many people have told me to put number 0 in a spray bottle and apply that way. Will that be an okay thing to do? And they replied with, we don't recommend spraying Olaplex products as it will irritate the mucous membranes. So none of their products should be sprayed, which this is the only one that's like a real liquid. So, but as soon as I read it will irritate the mucous membranes, I was like, so we shouldn't breathe that in. So that's a no-go. So I will not be spraying this and I'm glad I didn't. It doesn't smell like anything to me. It doesn't have like a scent, like a strong scent or anything that I noticed. But I won't be spraying this. Olaplex tells me not to, I'm not gonna spray it. There had to be a reason why it has this like really tiny little stream of product to apply. The instructions say, which I just told you guys, the instructions say saturate from root to tip, and I have very long hair. Will number 0 lose its effectiveness if water is added? And they said, we don't recommend adding water as it will alter the performance if it is diluted. And that makes sense. So they don't recommend adding water. I did it a couple times with adding a little bit of water after I applied this. And then because you need to have your hair like damp or wet for number 3 to do its job and work. So I didn't want to not apply enough water to my hair for number 3 to work, because I know that this works. I don't use number 0 every time I use number 3. I also tried number 0 without adding water the last time, undiluted, and it wasn't fully saturated, but it was like almost there, but I didn't add any extra water. And then I used number 3, and I personally did not see a big difference with using number 0. I honestly believe that it's because I don't have severe damage to my hair. So I personally didn't see a big benefit or a big difference than I would just using number 3. So for me, I'm not gonna repurchase number 0, but I wanted to give you guys my update on it. All right, my question's with number three. Remember, you use number three before you shampoo on damp hair. It's not a conditioner, it's a bond builder. The instructions say minimum of 10 minutes or longer. How long is that? So they said you can leave Olaplex number zero and Olaplex number three in longer. However, it won't be as effective after 30 to 45 minutes or when the hair is dry, which is honestly about how long I use it anyway, if I work out or whatever. We recommend to rinse it out, use Olaplex number four shampoo and Olaplex number five conditioner for best results. And I do use their shampoo and conditioner after I do my treatments too. I also asked them, could we sleep in number three even though it isn't as effective once the hair is dry? And they said, as a company, we do not recommend sleeping in Olaplex treatments as it could get into your eyes. However, we have received great feedback from people who have used it this way. So I personally do not sleep in treatments anyway. I've never slept with number three in my hair. But also, if you have watched my other videos, you know that I do shower at night and I like to go to bed with everything clean, head to toe, and I can definitely wait the 30 to 45 minutes and then finish shampooing and conditioning my hair. So that was their response on that. So I specifically asked them about the silicone in number six. This is their Bond Smoother. It's a leave-in reparative styling cream that reduces frizz, nourishes, and protects. And if you had seen my other videos, you know that I was talking about silicones and how my hair likes amodimethicone, but it typically does not like dimethicone. And I noticed that one of the ingredients in number six is dimethicone. So I specifically asked them, does the type of silicone used in Olaplex products build up on the hair? I was just asking in general about their products, but I was also speaking of dimethicone because of what I had read on number six. And they responded with, not all dimethicone are the same. There are 14 different types. We use the highest quality with the lowest molecular weight for our products, so it is easily washed away with shampoo and will not build up on the hair. We take great care in using the highest quality ingredients for our clients. The silicone we use in Olaplex is, I'll put it up here too, divinyl dimethicone, dimethicone copolymer, are water soluble. It's more pricey, lightweight, and doesn't build up like a traditional back-in-the-day silicone. We added it to our formula for shine, softness, and moisture retention. So that's perfectly fine with me. I was just curious if it would build up or not. I haven't noticed a problem or anything like that with their products, but I just wanted to ask since I was asking them all of these other questions already. So my update on number zero, I don't have severe damage. I don't personally notice a big difference when I use number zero on my hair versus when I don't. So number three, no surprise here if you watched my hair care routine video, but I still love number three and I will continue to use it in my routine. So that's it for the Olaplex update, and now let's get into your other questions. And like I said, I already answered a lot of questions, specifically ones that were like, what's your hair care routine? Or what do you do on a daily basis? Like things like that. And even just hair tips. I have all of those in my hair journey and hair tips video, as well as my hair care routine video. And I just posted those last week, so I'll link those below, but that has a lot more detailed information. There's still a couple questions in here that relates back to it. I'll also mention it as well. So this first question is a four-part question. They said, I'm currently trying to grow my hair and make it shiny and thicker. I'm obsessed with your hair. Thank you. I need your hair tips, like, how did you grow it out? So my hair has always been long, but a combination of everything in my hair journey and tips video will help. And what is your hair care routine? So I just posted my hair care routine video too. How often do you get a trim? So typically I get a trim every 6 months, and I have been cutting my own hair since last year, and I've done it twice now. So I wanna say every 4 to 6 months, but I don't cut a lot off. I like to keep the length, but yeah, I kind of shoot for every 6 months or so. Question number four is, how do you style it? So I keep my hair down, especially at night while it's air drying, but typically it's pulled up in a ponytail, sometimes a bun, but I just like it out of my face. My absolute favorite hairstyle though is a blowout. I'm not the best at figuring out the round brush technique though, because since I don't blow dry often, I don't get to practice very much, but my actual favorite hairstyle is a blowout. And my hair doesn't hold a curl, and I don't like product in my hair, so smooth and shiny it is. But day to day, it's in a ponytail. All right, next question is, have you tried rice water on your hair? No, I haven't tried it, and I don't think I will. It looks interesting, but no, I don't think I will, but I haven't tried it. Have you ever dyed your hair blonde or cut your hair super short? No, I've only highlighted my hair, and the shortest I've cut it is like a little bit past my shoulders, so like around here or so. But I was very upset and I missed it immediately. It's never been like higher than my shoulders. Have you had to deal with any hair loss? Yes. Postpartum with both girls, I lost the hair up at my temples. And then overall, I lost hair after I stopped breastfeeding them. And I stopped losing a lot of hair at once after a few months, but we're still working on regrowth though. I feel like it's always gonna be a constant battle with regrowth and preventing damage and breakage and all of that. So that's a journey. But yes, I'm still working on regrowth from the loss. How often do you wash your hair and how often would you recommend washing? So definitely check out my hair care routine video. But I do wash my hair every day, but I recommend washing it less often if you can, maybe every other day or every few days. I've also seen people after hair training that they can wash their hair less often, maybe once a week, but I would not go past once a week. I just feel like it's gross at that point. But I'm probably the wrong person to ask about that because since I'm washing my hair every night to get into bed, yeah, I wash my hair every day because I feel like I need to be clean head to toe to get into bed, but that's my own issue. But yes, I recommend washing it less often if you can get past that, which I'm just accepted that I wash my hair every day when I get a shower. So, do I use vitamins specifically for hair growth? No, I don't. I just use a regular multivitamin. Should you brush your hair when it's wet? I do after I spray with a detangling spray or my number six. But your hair is weakest when it's wet, so it's really not recommended. But if your brush glides easily through your hair, I personally don't see a problem with it. Not really saying it's the best thing to do, but I do it. What are your favorite hair ties since you like to wear your hair in a ponytail all the time? So this is in my hair care journey and tips video. I have really been loving velvet scrunchies, the Gimme Beauty hair ties as well. The spiral ones I also showed, I've used those in the past. So I use the spiral hair ties when I am doing my gloss treatment. The Ponyo I used to use as well, and they just don't stay very well in my hair, and they're just not my favorite. But I just grabbed one to show you guys what it looks like. I have used them in my videos before, but you just kind of open them up, put your hair in it and close it, and then you are supposed to fold. It just kind of folds. But they just don't stay well in my hair. They really didn't pull very much, so if you can get them to stay, then they're just not my favorite. So to answer the question, favorite hair ties are velvet scrunchies and the Gimme Beauty hair ties, and I talk about those in my tips video. I have thin hair. What can I do so it doesn't look flat and isn't a product I'd have to put in my hair? So if you blow dry, which I don't really have fine hair, I have like fine to medium, but if you blow dry, and if I really need volume, then I will blow dry my hair, but flip your head upside down, which I feel like I'm gonna mess my hair up if I do it, but flip your head upside down, and you can also kind of lift up on your hair as you're blow drying and styling, just kind of lift up and put it like opposite direction of the way it will lay, and that will help with the volume. But I don't really put product in my hair when I'm drying my hair, just the heat protectant. What is my quick routine and must-do steps? So check out my hair care routine video, but it's just the daily steps. I don't do anything extra most days anyway. What happened to Monate? Are you still using it? So I talk about Monate and all of the details in my hair journey video. Middle part or side part? Okay, my hair typically does fall in the middle, but if it is a side part, it's pretty close to the middle. So it could be just a little off on either side, but typically it's in the middle. What color was your hair when you were a baby? My hair has always been dark brown And what are your thoughts on using silicone in your hair care? Are they good or bad? So I talked about this some already, as well as in my hair journey video, but I learned that my hair doesn't like absolutely no silicones. My hair responds well to amidimethicone in my hair products typically. It selectively binds to damage and it doesn't build up on itself. And as I was saying about Olaplex, I typically don't like dimethicone. That's the type of silicone that will typically weigh your hair down and build up, and it's harder to remove. And then you would typically need a shampoo with sulfates to remove the buildup, which the sulfates are drying and stripping to the hair. It's a cycle that I don't want to be in, basically. Generally, good silicones are water soluble and bad silicones are not water soluble. So amidimethicone technically isn't water soluble, but since it doesn't build up, it rather binds to the damage and it protects the hair. I've just been loving it for me. I guess technically it depends on the molecular weight of the silicone that they're using. Like I was talking about Olaplex in the beginning of this video, how they use the lowest molecular weight of dimethicone and how it's more pricey and it's a highest quality. So it all depends on what brand and what the brand puts in the products. So right now I am still loving Olaplex as well as Pureology for my hair. And yeah, that's pretty much it. I feel like you guys have a pretty good idea what my hair routine is and the products I'm using and what I'm doing. So I hope they answered your questions and that you guys enjoyed the Olaplex update, and I will see you guys soon. Bye.